Hi,
I'm Angelica, and I try to keep this short to give you a short brother before I turn the stage over to Jack Halberstam. Firstly, I briefly outline how we at the Intermedia Art Institute are still in the early stages of our research on the topic of subcultures and the obstacles we face. Then I spin through the video program and provide you with brief info on the artists I've selected. Break down the walls. That's what New York straight edge hardcore band Youth of Today in their 1986 song of the same name are singing about when they're singing about fighting prejudice and discrimination. It seemed like the perfect companion for my preparations for this conference as I dug into the depths of the Intermedia Art Institute archives. When I first joined IMAI as a student assistant in 2015, the team was in the process of restructuring the archive, indexing it and preparing it for a new digitization process. To familiarize myself with the archive, I spent a lot of time between the shelves and the two very different parts of the archive. One part consisted of the works of the artists who were under distribution at the IMAI. This part is very well researched and documented. The other part is what we call Anlage 2, Annex 2, a cabinet of curiosities which internally took on an almost mystical character. This is only a part of Anlage 2. In Anlage 2 was everything that at first could not be used for anything. Unlabeled cassettes, VHS tapes, DVDs, a video of Soccer Club Fortuna Köln, and tapes from artists who had discontinued their collaboration with 235 or with IMAI at some point. Material that was not catalogued and whose contents and origin were unknown. Anlage 2 turned out to be a treasure trove. Looking for a topic for my master's thesis, I rummaged among the shelves where the videos were partly in two rows behind each other for the lack of space. And here I came across the flashy tapes of Joe Rees and Target 77 from San Francisco, known from their music video designs and recordings of Californian hardcore bands like Dead Kennedys or Black Flag or even The Cramps. I came across tapes by the Munich artist group Fun and Art with Andy Hinze and Alexander Ehrlich, which were colorfully spray-painted and pasted. Tapes with the inscriptions of German punk bands I knew from punk samplers like the Iron Curtain Records, video sampler or recordings from the Berlin Artenau Festival, which were put into a kind of rough audiovisual fanzine. And so I started looking further and discovered exciting material that helped us realize that 235 Media's music background was not just a youthful idea that they grew out of briskly. So how did this part of the collection's history fall into oblivion? By the interest shifting to video art and music getting a smaller and smaller role. At some point, after the founders Axel Wirz and Uli Leisner gave the collection out of their hands to form the Stiftung IMAI, the contextual knowledge to be able to link the names was missing. Among other things, because VHS tapes were not seen as an artistic, high-quality medium, but as an inexpensive medium for private home recording, which I find fatal, where now for the objects of my attention, exactly that format was deliberately chosen. All these works and videos have become storage memory, which I want to bring out again. Parts of this journey were published in 2020 in the volume Video Visions, edited by Renate Buschmann and Jessica Nietzsche. In it, we tried to record the history of the collection and its significance for the history of video art. Since 2015, with some breaks in between, I deal with these tapes, and with every new look at the collection, new connections open up to me. At the same time, every look and every new insight also evokes new questions. And I thank Linnea Semmerling for recognizing the potential of this part of the archive and bringing me on board for this project. In our preliminary discussions, we have become aware of how much our undertaking means and that we could develop two, if not even more, projects from it. In 6 months, I could not go as deep into the material as I would have liked. Research, viewing, and digitization would take much more time than I had actually available in this project. I tried to make a selection for the video program that was as diverse as possible. I have to admit, though, that we approached it a bit optimistically. It was difficult to find videos among the digitized material that come from or deal with the subculture and are by non-cis male artists. Here, I simply had to face the facts that the archive material from the label 235 Media reflects the perspective from which it was collected and distributed, white and cis hetero male. And that is now up to us to break this perspective and bring out the artists who have been forgotten. And as I sat on the panel of an online lecture on the future of the artistry recently, a colleague asked if we need to keep up bringing up the gender issue, like for example when it comes to analyzing a statue of Mary. And I think this conference and the other interviewers will answer that question quite clearly. Instead of pursuing thematic issues, I have selected works that I think give a good audiovisual impression of how subcultures can function as a field of experimentation and a network for artists. Due to their proximity to subcultures and their distinctive aesthetics, these artists have become marginalized in an art form that itself holds an outsider position in the art world. They have become the fringe of the fringe, as video artists and also as punks. I'm not a big fan of anticipating interpretation, so I will now provide you with some background information on the artists and the making of the videos. So the first picture is of Akiko Harada's The Fall of the Queen, or The Taste of the Fruit to Come, that Elfie already mentioned. It's a perfect example of how certain protagonists always cross my path during research, and also about that of the Tödliche Doris. Akiko Harada not only documented the London punk scene with a photo camera, she also produced videos for the art project The Tödliche Doris, which proves to be the linchpin here. Wolfgang Miller, a founding member of Tödliche Doris, wrote the script, and we will meet him again tomorrow night for his performance. And Hermoine Ziedlau plays the Queen. Mark Brandenburg, today a well-known artist, meets us as a dancer. Hermoine Ziedlau and Mark Brandenburg have already worked together with Wolfgang Müller for projects of the Tödliche Doris, and both have appeared in the punk scene. Gunther Trube, gay deaf activist and sign poet, gave the opening speech for the first solo exhibition of Tödliche Doris in 1990, and he did this in German sign language. In the video opera of Akiko Harada, or by Akiko Harada, he acts as the Queen's advisor. The singing in this video opera is improvised. The mainly German speakers chose their own melody and tempo. The music was added later. In some places, the text is a bit difficult to understand, but don't worry, there will be a briefly summation at the plot, from the plot at the end of the act. Next picture, Norbert Meissner accompanied under the pseudonym Propaganda Video various German punk bands around the Hannover No Fun record label, and also bands from Düsseldorf with this camera. For example, Deutsch-Amerikanische Freundschaft, Die Toten Hosen, or Rotzkotz. In his compilation Freies Deutschland, Meissner takes the DIY Zion format and transfers it to the video. Similarities can be seen to Joe Rees with Target Video 77 from San Francisco, who I already mentioned. The selected video is a compilation of music videos of the band Abwärts for the songs Computerstart, Roboter in der Nacht, Robots at Night, and Für Mutti. Worst German music, as the narrator introduces. Then we come to Strafe für Rebellion, who have been moving between the art and music worlds since 1979, and are more of a project than a band. Thousand Heads Are Fond of Rolling is a 60mm film from 1983, and the song of the same song of the same name appeared on the album A Soundless Message of Death, which was produced by Alfred Hilsberg. They don't play any instruments, friends had to be asked for that. Much more, they arrange noises from the noise archive. While here the reference to the Düsseldorf subculture scene can still be heard very clearly, the sound becomes more and more experimental over the years. And there's a little fun fact, Siegfried M. Senjuga was also a founder of a founding member of Spex, a German very famous music magazine. PM magazine Acid Rock is one of four channels of an installation for Documenta 7 in 1992. It's the picture on the right. In it, Dara Birnbaum reinterprets the song LA Woman by The Doors and collages clips of women from the television program PM magazine. It seems as if the woman at the Wang computer is programming not only the television program, but also the little ice cream licking girl and her career that you are seeing in this picture. Ann Wilson and Marty St. James shoot the high heel in the video Tomboy Tom Girl, which is part of the visual art songs for the 80s series. With toys and cross-dressing, they explore what little girls and boys are made of. The next artist is a little gem that we found at the archive. Rabe Perplexum is the non-binary art figure of Manuela Hahn from Munich, who attracted attention with their white outfits and self-deprecating performances. And the Munich Literature Archive houses the artist's estate, and it has been dedicated to their memory since last year and is trying to bring the name into the public eye. When I came across their work in the EMI archive in 2015-2016, I could not yet find any information about the Rabe and the works. All the more I'm happy that the history narrative of the Munich art and also of the Munich punk scene has become a bit more clear. In preparation for his career as live sports and show director and producer, Jonathan X used his breaks to experiment with video effects layered over his audio tracks. His work uses psychedelic elements and quick cuts, criticizing the political circumstances in the United States of the 1980s and discrimination against black people. The program is closed by Pyroartist Kein Caravan, who together with Tom Scapoda sets the west side of the Berlin Wall on fire in unannounced nightly actions. Schade, dass Beton nicht brennt. Too bad, concrete doesn't burn. As the documentary of the same name about the Berlin squatter scene of 1981 says. You can see the video program Break the Walls in our video launch by going downstairs, turning right and following the sound through the end of the exhibition room. And if you have only tuned in online, you can view part of the program on our website, on our video art channel Play. Oh, by the way, I have created a playlist, a Spotify playlist, that collects the songs, or at least the musicians who are mentioned in the lectures and in this conference. Just search for Fringe of the Fringe in the playlist section. With this, you can tune in tonight for the next days.